You can buy shares in a company that you like, but how can you sell shares in a company that you don't own? You do something called short selling or shorting. If you do it right, you can make a big quick buck, but if you get it wrong, you'll regret taking the risk more than anything. What is going on YouTube? Welcome back to the channel. You're probably here because you've seen the world go GameStop, Reddit, Wall Street Bets mad, and you want to find out what this thing called shorting or short selling actually is and how you might be able to do it in the financial markets. In this video, I'll explain in plain English what shorting is and how a lot of investors in the financial markets make use of it as an investment or trading strategy. So without any further ado, let's get straight to it. Alright, let's cut to the chase and answer the big question. What is short selling or what is shorting? When you like a company and you think its share price is going to go up, you buy it and therefore you go long. When you don't like a stock or company and you think the share price is going to fall, you sell it and so you go short. Your profit is the difference between when you bought it and when you sold it, or vice versa. Simple. However, it's easy to buy shares in a stock or a company that you like because you just go to the financial markets and you buy shares of that company. But how can you sell stock in a company if you think its share price is going to fall, especially if you don't own shares in that company in the first place? Simple answer, you borrow them. And this is where shorting comes in. The first man to short a stock was called Isaac Lemaire, and he was from the Netherlands, and he did so around 400 years ago. So this investment strategy has been around for a very long time. First, we need to begin with a few assumptions. So one, let's assume that you own Google shares. Let's assume that the Google shares are currently trading at $10 a share, and let's assume that I think personally the price of Google shares are overpriced, and so in a week or two they're gonna drop. So three assumptions, right? As a result, I want to short Google stock because I think the price is gonna drop, and so here's what I do. I reach out to you and I say, hey, let me borrow a Google share from you. It's currently at $10. I'll give it back to you next week, guaranteed. And on top of that, for your trouble, I'll give you some interest. So I'll give you a dollar or two as a fee for you lending it to me. So you think, okay, I'm not doing anything with my Google shares. I might as well lend them out and get some interest on top. So you give me a Google share. It's worth $10. What I do next is I go to the markets and I sell that share. So I still owe you a share, but I've sold your $10 Google share in the market. And then what happens is I get $10 in return. So I've given the market a Google stock and I've received $10 in cash. So I'm up $10. Happy days. Now I need to patiently wait for the Google stock price to fall from $10 to a lower price. When that happens, and if that happens, this is what I'm going to do. Next week comes around, and would you believe it, the price of Google stock has fallen from $10 down to $5. So I've got $10 cash, remember? So what I'm going to do now is go back to the market and buy one Google stock for $5. And so I get that Google stock and I give it back to you, and I give you $1 on top as a fee for borrowing it from you in the first place. So I've used my $10 cash, I've spent $5 on a Google stock, given your stock back to you, and then I gave you $1 on top as a fee. In the end, I have $4 profit, and that's what I keep for myself. And I get that because I was able to predict the price of Google stock falling from $10 down to some point. In this case, it was $5. And so I made a profit on that short sale. If you multiply this by tens of millions of dollars, this is what big financial institutions and hedge funds are doing every single day in the financial markets. They're predicting, or they're looking at companies that are performing poorly, and they're predicting their downfall, and they're trying to capitalize off of that. This is all good and well if the price that we predicted to drop actually drops. However, what happens if the price actually increases? If you buy a $10 stock and the price goes up to 12 and then you sell it at 12, you get a $2 profit, right? Between $10 and $12, that's your profit. You make $2, done. However, let's say you invest in a stock for $10 and then the company's in the news for all the wrong reasons, and then their share price goes down to zero. You lose all the money you invested, so you lose $10, and that's the most that you can lose. You can't lose any more than the $10. This unfortunately isn't the case for going short. When you go long, your losses are limited to the amount that you invest. However, when you go short, your losses, or your potential losses, are unlimited. Here's how. In my first example, I borrow a Google stock from you, which costs $10. I sell it in the market and hope for the price to go down. It goes down to $5 and I make profit, right? However, let's say I sell it in the market and then that Google share price a week later goes up to $50. Instead of going down, it goes up. And at this point, I need to give you back your Google share, right? So I need to go into the market, buy that contract or buy that share from the market for $50 and give it back to you. The problem is, I still owe you one Google share regardless of the price. Me and you entered into a contract, a legally binding contract that says I need to give you one Google share back regardless of the price a week from the date that I borrowed it from from you. So I need to go into the market and buy a $50 Google share and give that to you. So now that's gonna hurt me. It's gonna put me into negative as opposed to the price going down and me buying it at a cheaper rate and giving it to you for cheaper. I took it from you at $10. I sold it at $10, so I've got $10 cash, but the price went up to $50. Now I need to go back and buy it. So I am gonna buy it at $50, which means I'm down $40, and then I give that to you. So overall, my bet, my prediction didn't play out. I'm not in profit. I'm actually at a loss of $40. So this, as you can see, is where the risk comes in. What if the price went up to $100 or $200 or $300? It could keep going up. The higher it goes, the more I suffer from my short position. And this is why short positions are hugely risky, because your losses or your potential losses can be unlimited. This is exactly what happened to many of the hedge funds that shorted the GameStop stock. They predicted the share price on GameStop to drop. However, the price did the complete opposite. Because of all the online forums, the Wall Street Bets forums on Reddit, and many other factors, the price of GameStop actually went up. This forced a lot of hedge funds to close out of their short positions, so they had to buy the stock at a higher price in order to get it and return the stock to whoever they borrowed it from, and as a result they suffered huge losses. And once you're being forced to close a short position, it's basically called a short squeeze. So you might have heard of the infamous short squeeze. This is where the price of the stock is going up and up and up, but you've got a short position, and in order to cut your losses you need to buy back the stock and return it prematurely, and so that is basically a short squeeze. So one of the big losers from this movement in GameStop stock was a hedge fund called Melvin Capital. In October 2020, the price of GameStop stock was around $10 per share, and they predicted that it's going to go lower. However, by the end of January 2021, the share price reached a high of around $350. Melvin Capital lost billions of dollars as a result of this, and part of the reason is that because hedge funds tend to take a lot of leverage, so they magnify or amplify the level of their trades by taking on debt, and so the portion or the size of their trades is a lot bigger than what it might be without taking on the debt. And so their potential wins are a lot bigger, but on the flip side, their potential losses are also a lot bigger than what they might be if you don't use leverage. What is leverage? Leverage is basically the ability to amplify the size of a trade by taking on debt. So you borrow money and then you use that money to invest alongside your previous capital, and so it just makes your potential wins larger and your potential losses larger. So it does come with risk, but it also has upside, and that's why a lot of hedge funds which take on risky bets tend to use a lot of leverage when they invest. If you want to try your hand at investing in the stock market, you can get a free share worth up to £200 by signing up to free trade by using the link in the video description. If you do that, we'll both get a free share worth up to £200, and you can start investing from as little as £2. If you enjoyed this video, leave a like, smash the subscribe button, let me know your thoughts and opinions and questions in the comments below, and I will see you in the next video. Peace. If you want a free premium trial to my Skillshare courses on investment banking and creating a strong CV, hit the link in the video description and you can get a free trial for 2 weeks on Skillshare.